Now, friends, did it ever happen to you to create a slicer by product color, start using it, and after a few days, a nasty black row appears in the slicer? You search in the product table, there are no rows anywhere without the color. Still, that row is there, and it's breaking the beauty of your report. Now, you could get rid of the blank in that specific slicer by using a filter, but you are creating more problems than you are solving. Because if blank suddenly appears in your data, that means you have an invalid relationship. And the blank row is a very important concept that you need to understand well in DAX. Because if a model contains a blank row, then you need to pay attention to a lot of your calculation to make sure that you are doing them right. So, in this video, I will walk through understanding why the blank row might appear in the model, how to get rid of it, and what you need to pay attention to whenever you have blank rows in your tables. Let's get started. In order to understand the concept well, we will do several steps. We start with a model that does not contain any blank row and works just fine. Then I will artificially create the blank row. And in the process, I will explain you the reason why the blank row appears. After that, we will see which functions use the blank row, which functions do not use them, and what are the dangers that you might have because of the blank row. So, let's start with a model that works just fine. I have a report that is slicing by color, the sales amount, and I have a slicer that contains category. You see, there are no blanks anywhere. Now focus on this value. Black has 5 million, around $6 million of sales. And the model is working just fine. I'm slicing by color. Now, the color is one of the columns in the product table. It's here. And when I slice by color, I can compute values from sales because the filter moves from product to sales because of the relationship. And this relationship right now is valid. All the rows in sales point to the right product. So everything is working just fine. But what happens if I remove one of the colors? Let's say, for example, that I remove the black color from the model. Therefore, all the products which are black suddenly disappear. What is the engine expected to do at this point about these $6 million? Well, because there are no products, if I slice by product, they might disappear. But this is bad because I will no longer have the correct total. So the engine is going to create a blank row, a row that does not exist in the model, contains a blank, that is related to all the products that previously were in the model, the black products, and they suddenly disappeared. This row appears in the model even though you cannot see it. Let's do it together. To artificially create the blank row, I need to go to transform data and get rid of all the products which are red. So I go to the product table, select red from somewhere, search for it, here it is. Just right click, text filters, and keep only the rows which are not black. I do close and apply, this refreshes the model, and now black is no longer here, and you see what happened? I have the blank row here in category that was not present earlier, and I also have a blank here in product that contains exactly the same amount of products that were previously in the model. I can go searching for this row. I can go in the product table. Let me search for it. Let's go to color. I can sort it ascending. Look at the detail, but you see that the first color is azure. There are no rows anywhere that contain this blank. Nevertheless, the blank row was inserted. So right now, my product table contains all the products that have been loaded from the data model, plus an additional row containing a blank, which is used to justify to relate to all the rows that are now orphaned from their product. And the value you see here is still correct. The report still reports the correct total because of the blank row. So the blank row has a very good reason of being. It exists in order to make a relationship that is invalid still work. Nevertheless, you need to pay attention to the presence of the blank row. First of all, it breaks your slicer. Now you have under category also the category blank. Again, there are no products with a blank category, except from the product containing the blank row, or for the blank row in the product table. As I said, this is an artificial row. It does not exist in the model, but it is counted. Some functions count it, some functions do not. And we need to understand which function consider the blank row as a valid row and which functions do not. For example, I might be interested in counting the number of products, and I can create a measure that does just count rows of product. If I put this measure in the report, look what happens. For every color, I have the correct number of products, except for the blank. In the blank row, I don't see any products, as if there were none. And it's an interesting question. Are there any products which are blank? If you look at the data loaded from the database, there are none. But if you consider the table as it is after DAX processed it, it actually contains that row. If you want to see that product, you cannot use just count rows of product. You need to use count rows values of product. Values used with a table argument does not return only the table, but the table plus the additional blank row if it exists. If I put values, count rows values of product, now you see that I see 1 in the blank. The reason is values considers the blank row, a table reference does not. And this is not the only function that has a difference in the handling of the blank row. Distinct and values, for example, they are two functions that do nearly the same thing. They return the distinct values of a column, but distinct does not consider the blank row, whereas values does. Let's see that with an example. Let's get rid of number of products and sales amount, we can keep it. Let's say that I create a new measure that counts the number of colors which are present in the model. So I create a measure, number of colors, which is count rows of distinct of product color. I am using distinct, so the blank row will not be taken into account. And if I put that in the report, you see that it shows 1 everywhere and 15 are the total. What if I want to see 1 also here? Well, instead of using distinct, I need to use values. Let's call this measure number of colors distinct. And I can create a new measure. I just copy the previous code. This is number of colors with values that instead of using distinct, uses values. If I put that in the report, now you see that I have 1. And also the total is different. The thing that the total is different is very important because depending on the function you use, you might have different results. For example, you might be interested in computing the percentage of products of every brand compared with the total. Let's do that. Let's say that I want to compute the percentage of product, the number of product divided by the total number of product. I can compute the percentage using values or using distinct. Using distinct. And it's a division. I divide the count rows of product by calculate count rows of product. I can actually make it easier by count rows all product. This counts the number of products in the current filter context. This counts the number of all products, and the division one of the other produces a percentage. I put that in the report, drop it here, and look at the result. Let's see the formula too. Percentage. Yeah, this is just percentage without distinct. Look at the total here. It's 99.95%. Why is it not 100%? The reason is I do at the top, I'm using count rows product. Count rows does not count the blank row. At the denominator, I'm using count rows of all product. all considers the blank row. So the denominator contains not only the number of products which I loaded from the database, but also the one containing the blank row. If I want to fix it, or if I want to obtain a good percentage, I can do two things. Either I count the blank row also at the numerator, or I do not count the blank row at the denominator. So I can do count rows of values of product. If I use count rows of values of product, then also at the numerator, I will consider the blank row. And if you focus at the total here, you will see that as soon as I hit enter, this will go to 100%. If I do not want to consider the blank row, neither at the numerator, neither at the denominator, then I should not use values, I should use distinct product or just product, because a table reference by itself does not consider the blank row. And instead of using all, I use all no blank row product. Now this does not consider the blank row, and this does not consider the blank row. Again, the total will be 100%. And you see that I still have 100%. The presence of the blank row in your model always comes from an invalid relationship. If a relationship between two tables is not valid because some of the values in sales reference products that do not exist, then the engine creates the blank row. And the presence of the blank row is important because all of your calculation might consider or not the blank row. We have seen distinct and values, but there are a lot of other calculations that might be broken because in part of the calculation you are considering the blank row and in another part you are not. So the best thing that you can do is check the model for invalid relationship. If a blank row appears from nowhere, that means that you have an invalid relationship somewhere. You need to search for it, fix it, and that is the best way of solving the issue. If you cannot fix the problem for whatever reason, then you will need first to understand that the blank row exists for a reason. If you hide it, you will hide the values of all the invalid rows, producing totals which are not correct. And if the blank row appears in your model, pay attention to all of your calculation and ask yourself if you are considering or not the blank row in every step of your calculation. Mixing part of calculation that does not use the blank row with part that use it is likely to produce wrong results. Enjoy DAX.